of a wild style.
That's the art that you're not expecting. Sometimes it happens in places where you don't expect it, sometimes at times when you don't. We're sitting in a theater, we expect performances, but I bet you weren't expecting that. That was Pones, is a local group. They did the choreography and they worked with about 25 volunteers who didn't know what they were signing up for, but practiced the last few nights and they had a great time preparing the surprise for you. So let's thank them. We also find this kind of serendipitous art, unexpected art, in places we don't expect to see it. So I'm going to share some of that with you. I discovered this one night driving home from work in a field in a park, hundreds of pinwheels, blue and silver pinwheels. No explanation, no artist signature, but lots of people like me walking through it, looking around, wondering what it was all about, talking to each other. This kind of art, when we've discovered it's not in a theater, it's not in a gallery, it's just not where we expect to see it. And it has its own kind of magic, like this truck. Sometimes we see art on streets and sidewalks where we don't expect to see it. This is Pones, again, doing some sidewalk performance art at Sycamore and 13th Street. Sidewalk performance art makes us engaged and interested, curious, talking to people around us. In this case, if you'd walked by, you would have wondered what they're doing. You're probably wondering now. And you would have probably stopped to see. These two young music students at CCM, performed just across the street from here at 6th and Walnut one night. They just pulled out their instruments and started playing. They weren't asking for money. They were taking it if it was offered. This is some visual art on a sidewalk. This is more common. We see it. It's not legal, usually, in most places. Sometimes, like in this case, it's very visible and we can't miss it. Other times, we have to look for it in order to see it, like these times. Sometimes we see art that is just text, right? This artist is in the neighborhood around my office building, putting the word love on the sides of buildings in slightly hidden places. It's really fun to discover. This artist used a mailbox for a canvas, put up something I found personally kind of interesting enough to take a picture of it and save it. And then this artist, actually this looks like maybe a collaboration of some kind, put it on the side of a building that was on my way to work, and it made me smile every day when I drove by until someone painted over it. And then I was disappointed and started to think about how do we really foster the kind of serendipity and serendipitous art, the surprise art that engages us and makes places that we want to be and that we like being in. Sometimes we see visual art like this that's more traditional, but he doesn't feel planned or programmed like part of something that got a permit. He's in Northside. She's in Brighton, where lots of artists live and work. And then we see store window art. It's designed to engage us. Some of it's more engaging than others. This is in Northside, which has a lot of great store window art. This is on Main Street, and this is on Vine Street. I love serendipitous art so much, I decided I wanted to paint a street, I mean the actual pavement of a street. So I talked to some people at City Council. You have to actually get permission because it's illegal to paint the pavement, and found five local artists who wanted to help create it. We had a community meeting to get input into what the design should be, and then 100 people got together to help organize something special, and on a day in September, 1,500 people came together to paint a half mile of pavement. This is what happened. Serendipitous art like this, like Paint the Street, reminds us that, you know, art brings people together, engages us, leaves our neighborhoods and communities colorful, engaging, interesting, places we want to be. We need to foster this kind of serendipity, create more magic of our own. I think we should all work hard to foster serendipitous art. Thank you.